Alright, it's time to remove the alternator pulley. I've got three different size crescent wrenches, an 8 inch, a 10 inch, and a 12 inch. I'm going to try to use the 12 inch. And then I've got a big flathead screwdriver. What I don't want to do is smack my knuckles down there on the bottom. Give this a shot. That ain't working. Time for a different screwdriver. A little one might work. Does it need to be so tight? Okay, let's try here. There we go. It looks like having this horizontal helped a little bit, having this screwdriver horizontal. Now we'll switch down to the shorter one. Yeah. Okay, now how this comes apart is important. All right, see how the fan belt has now slackened a bit? I hope that came out okay. I have now loosened the nut on the alternator. I used this, in case this is filmed into the sun, I used this 12-inch adjustable crescent wrench. Well, that might be redundant. And a flathead screwdriver wedged in horizontally into there. And now, look at these parts as they come out. Alright? So first you have the nut. Okay? Then you have this little thing. It's kind of like a witch's hat, just cut off at the top. See that? Alright. Come on. There we go. Alright. And that went on there like so, right? Okay. Alright. And now, a few of these little spacers. Okay. It's supposed to be 10 of them, so there might be a few in there. Then, this. Don't get the cheap one of these. Get the expensive one. Looks good. Not too beat up at all. There's the fan belt. We'll put that to the side for now. Look at all these shims. How many shims do you think there are? Shim. There's a shim joke in there somewhere. One, two. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. That's about right. 10, 11. All right? Now, that doesn't mean that you put nine in here and then put two there. It might be 7 and 4. It might be 10 and 1. You don't know. But what you have to do is, it's a little trial and error. Or it's a lot of trial and error. You have to see how much play there is in the fan belt. So you put them on, you tighten it down, and if there's too much play in the fan belt, then you've got to or not enough play in the fan belt, you have to add or subtract shims, because you need there to be the exact right amount of play in your fan belt. I think it's about a half an inch of play. I don't know how many centimeters that is. And so you add shims here, or you add shims in between these two, and it makes, and the reason why it does that is because these pulleys, each side of the pulley is tapered. So you can see the taper in there. One's at an angle like this, and the other side's at an angle like that, right? See, see the flat side here, that's flat. But on the inside of this piece, that's at an angle. Same thing with the other side. So if you put more shims in, it spreads these apart, and the fan belt can go deeper into the crevice, deeper into that canyon there. That makes sense? But if you put in less shims, then these two pieces come together further, closer. They come together closer, and the fan belt can't go down as far, because the fan belt's only a certain width, right? It's going to be blocked. And as the fan belt can go in further or not, it becomes looser or tighter in this area right in here. Anyway, that's the concept. We'll refine that later. I'm going to leave these on here. Where did that fan belt stuff together? There we go.